Hello, Malty Mistopheleses. And thank you to Void and Tuesday for that malt mention. Introducing Whisky Review 362, Part 3 of 7, which is a short series following on from a recent visit to the Spirit of Toronto Whisky Gala. And thank you, by the way, to everybody who at the gala who made me so welcome, and all the photographs and the wee present of a cigar, and also the present of a miniature of whisky. Thank you, you lovely people. I was genuinely surprised, and it was charming to get all the kind of fuss and attention, because here in the Manx Bothy, there tends to be no fuss and attention whatsoever, and to get that sort of feedback beyond comments and Facebooky stuff was a rare and much appreciated treat. Talking of treats, a very easy link in to 40 Creek Copper Pot, which not available outside of Canada yet, but if you're in Canada or North America, say if you're in Boston, you might be able to pick up a bottle somewhere, or Chicago. The 40 Creek Distillery, or should I say the 40 Creek Whiskey from Kittling Ridge Distillery, is a small distillery located in Grimsby, just south of Toronto and just sort of north of the Niagara Falls, halfway in between. And a chap called John, who started life as a fairly successful wine producer, at some point decided to move on to distillation, and has successfully introduced a new form of Canadian whisky into what is a very conservative whisky producing country, Canada, where you don't tend to get a lot of innovation, frankly, and I mean that objectively. And why innovate when your product's selling successfully? Absolutely. But they're doing things a little bit different at 40 Creek. Primarily what they're doing is they are distilling using both pot and column stills. Rye whiskey, corn whiskey and barley whiskey. And importantly, as well as producing them separately, they are maturing them separately in specifically prepared casks. So the corn the corn spirit goes into charred casks. The barley spirit goes into toasted casks, and the rye spirit goes into its own specifically prepared style of cask. And it is only at the point prior to bottling that the blenders will put the different grains together to create a flexible style of whiskey. You'll mainly see Barrel Select out there, which is a good, decent quality young whiskey. I've gone for the Copper Pot because essentially it's the Barrel Select with extra rye, and I like rye, I like young rye. So I'm going to give you tasting notes. Here we are. Interestingly, bottled at 43% when the vast majority of Canadian spirits are bottled at a basic 40. So we're a step in the right direction already. Now, very much a young spirit. No big signs of maturity here because the distillery is not old enough to have prominent mature stocks to put into standard blends. Rye fruit, honey, mixed grain, vanilla, mixed fruit juices, fresh fruit juices, and buttermints. And in the taste, and I do recommend Not much, just a drop of water. Sweet and spicy rye rich arrival. Evolves dry, ginger, tannin, cinnamon, camphor, licorice. It's a fairly swift arrival and a fairly swift development. It kind of shows its youthfulness. Laterally in the development, mint and fennel. And with a drop of water, you'll find a big chocolate moment lasts a wee while. Prior to turning sweet and sour toffee rye. And the finish, mint, fruit and vanilla with a touch of sour tannins. No caramel? I don't think so. Having been invited along to visit Forty Creek Distillery and getting to taste a few samples at the sample table, along with a couple of sandwiches and a big glass of water, certainly I enjoyed my visit to the distillery. In that you can always gauge the calibre of a distillery by the standards in the warehouse. How serious a distiller takes maturation. And what I noticed unusually going into the Forty Creek warehouses, which aren't normally open, they do have a shop there if you're passing. You can certainly buy a good range of what they produce. The Confederation Oak, by the way, is probably the one to look out for. Costs a bit more, but you're getting mature spirits noticeable in that particular variety of Forty Creek. But you don't normally have access to the warehouses because of the layout of their operation. But the thing that struck me going into the warehouse was the fact that I couldn't smell much alcohol. In some warehouses, you get quite a pungent waft of alcohol. Not because of Angel's Share, but because of leaking. And the standards of stacking of casks themselves, the palletage system, very professionally done. And that, I think, reflects potentially in the future of the bottlings from this particular distillery. At the moment, a modest 83 out of 100, and that is, of course, because it's rye, barley and corn, it's a blend whisky. It's kind of tempting when you visit smart distilleries which are being genuinely innovative to kind of want to rave a wee bit about them, just to kind of shout them out to get some attention on the international scene, on the online. But it's early days yet at Forty Creek. It's still relatively young spirit, hence the mark, 83 out of 100. But what I am noticing from some of the samples that I was cross-referencing is the calibre of maturation that's taking place. You're getting much more complexity starting to appear within older casks of Forty Creek. And I do suspect that there's going to be bottlings out which are going to be genuine Canadian classics. But for the price, $28.55, if you're in Ontario, bang for your buck, whisky, can't beat it. Anything else I want to add? No, that's everything said. I'd conclude by saying that all around the world you're seeing more distilleries appearing. And one of the worst mistakes I think a distillery can make is to kind of look at what's the established perception of whisky, Scotch whisky, malt, single malt in particular, and just try and mimic it. Just try and copycat the established world-leading brand and just hope for the best. But in fact, the real skill is for a distiller to look around them at what they have, what the historical prerogative, the custom and practice in the area is in terms of spirits. And rather than imitate a Scotch, is recreate, redefine, reinterpret a spirit that already comes from the area. As whether you want to do that in malted barley, in corn, in rye, or a combination of all three, or just two, is entirely up to the distiller. But it's having the confidence and assertiveness to create your own stills, deciding your own combinations and mixes, and importantly, do what they've done at 40 Creek. Develop the product first before really putting it out in the market. And I think that's one reason for their success and why they get attention. Anyway, I'm Ralphie. That is my opinion. I hope it helps. Hope you find it useful. And we'll be back with Whisky Vlog 362, part 4. In which I interview John Hall, the proprietor and master distiller at 40 Creek Distillery. And he's going to introduce us to a very specific little thing, very interesting little thing that's happening at 40 Creek Distillery. Thanks for watching. Hope you find this helpful, useful, and giving you a valuable insight to Canadian whisky stuff at the moment. I'm Ralphie, happy to help. Come back soon where you'll be experiencing another little malt moment in a different on location permutation. Thanks for watching now. Bye bye.